Hi folks, Will from MinIO here, and in this second video around getting started with MinIO AIStor, I'm going to walk you through a little demo around installing and running both AIStor and the MinIO command line client. Let's go ahead and take a look. Okay, let's take a look at our environment here. I'm actually running this in just a simple virtual machine that I'm running on Lima. And if I do a uname-a, so you can see what I've got, I've actually got a very simple Rocky Linux deployment I'm running on ARM64. So I'm not actually using AMD, I'm using ARM, but this is just a very basic Linux setup so that I can actually deploy this. So the first step that I'm going to do is, as noted, I'm going to do that sudo dnf install. And let me just go ahead and copy paste that URL because that is a long URL. But this is the MinIO RPM. It's on dl.min.io. And I'm going to go ahead and hit enter. Yep, I know that I have to do this. There we go. And it's going to download that MinIO RPM and we're going to go ahead and install it. Notice that this is the version from literally a couple of weeks ago. We'll go ahead and run this. There we go. And we are complete. We have completed my install here. Now, as I noted, you need to actually have an etc defaults so that you can run your system. So I'm going to go ahead and do a sudo vi etc default MinIO. And here in this etc default MinIO is where we're actually going to set up all of our details. So the first thing I'm going to need to do here is I'm going to change this. And since I'm running on a virtual system, I'm going to actually put all my data in temp Lima data because I'm running on this. This is a very simple Lima setup here. I'm going to change my console options here. Let's change that. We're going to use port 9000 for my API. We're going to use port 9090 for my console access. There we go. And I'm going to set my user and password. This one says change me. It's going to default to MinIO admin if I don't change it. So let's go ahead and change this. So we'll make this admin root. And since I'm not going to type worst password ever, I'm going to go ahead and use do not use this. Okay. The end file there, I'm going to not worry about this. This is where it's going to look by default, but there is one other thing I do need to add, and that is the MinIO license file. And that MinIO license, I've actually already installed it here in my virtual machine. It's under opt MinIO, MinIO license. But of course, you can put it anywhere you like. Just make sure you tell the system where it is. And there it is. We've set up our etc default MinIO. And what we're going to do now is we're going to do a sudo systemctl start MinIO. And that's it. We're good to go. If I do a sudo systemctl status MinIO, we are up and running. And you can see there's the service where we're set. All of our connections are good to go. And at this stage, I can go ahead and log in. So let me go ahead and transfer over. Clear this, and we're going to transfer over to a browser window. And here we have our MinIO Enterprise Object Store. This is our AI Store Object Store. We're going to go ahead and log in as admin root, and our password, do not use this. And there it is. As you can see, we've got our full management console available here. You can see what version we're running. I can create buckets with versioning and all that other fun stuff. My bucket, for instance, and we'll go ahead and create that bucket. And this allows me to manage the entire system through this console. Now, if I don't want to use the console and I want to use the command line, I need to install that command line client. And back in our virtual environment again, I'm going to do that sudo dnf install, and we're going to go ahead and install that enterprise CLI right there. So again, this is ARM64. But MC-Enterprise RPM, this is what we're going to install. And when we install this, notice it installs MCLI. Those of you who are coming to us from previous versions, you may have noticed that it's no longer just MC. Now, the reason why it's no longer just MC is because MC is a command that was used by another tool that's very common on Linux. And so we have changed ours to MCLI for the purposes of integration. So we're going to go ahead and say yes. We'll go ahead and run that. And now I'm going to do an MCLI alias set. I'm going to call this local. We're going to connect to http://localhost. Notice now I'm going to use the API port and not the console address. And we're going to go to admin root and do not use this. Okay. And when we set that up, we have now initialized everything that we need and we've added local successfully. So let's go ahead and do an MCLI admin info local. And when we do that MCLI info admin local, what we get is our local host has been up for 3 minutes. We've got one drive. Everything is happy. And from here, I can do all that fun stuff that I need to do with any other tools that I might need to have. And that's going to conclude our video on getting started with MinIO AIStor. If you're ready to learn more about MinIO AIStor, we have both self-paced and live training available for topics such as versioning, LDAP integration, lifecycle management, replication, object retention, the load balancer, the KMS, all available. You can reach us at training@min.io. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you'd like to reach out with us, you can use any of the methods you see here on the screen, or you can Slack us on slack.min.io, or just leave a comment here on the video.